What is up, YouTube? Thrift School over here, outside of a pretty big Goodwill. Have I ever been to this one? Honestly, I have no idea. Maybe once or twice in my life, but not in a long time. Let's do it. All right, after being in here a little bit, I know I've definitely been in here before. I'm trying to remember where the toys are, and I think they're right around the corner here. Yeah, they are. Okay, they got a whole bunch of stuff we're gonna have to look through. If I see something good, you guys will see it too. Taking a look at the toys section, and I saw this down here for $1.99. That's Princess Peach. This is a Mario castle. It's kind of cool. And it opens up. I'll show you guys. I got it open earlier. I don't even know how I opened it before. Let's see if I can get this thing open again. There we go. I got it all open. It's a playset. It should come with a Mario and some other characters, I think. Here's the Bullet Bill. And you run Mario through his course and you hit things. It's kind of cool. It does close up, and we have a couple issues. The first issue is there's no characters. The second issue, one of the flags looks like it's snapped off. So even at $1.99 complete, it only sells for about $25. It's cool, but we're leaving it. All right, this is pretty sweet. 1313 Dead End Drive. I normally see the newer version of this game with a long box, but this square box right here I never see, and it's only $1.99. I'll pop the price up for you guys. Take a look at that. Sells pretty well, so we're gonna grab it. It's an over $20 profit. Throw it in the cart. Another game we got right here is a brand new sealed Candyland Chocolate Edition. Luckily, it's brand new sealed because there's food in here. It's only $1.99, so that's pretty cool. I actually might end up keeping this and playing this with my mom because she's visiting right now, and it just looks like fun. I'd make a little bit of money on it, but I don't know how comfortable I feel selling chocolate from a thrift store online, even though it is sealed. So you could probably get away with it, but it's cool for $2. I'll pop the price up anyways for you guys so you can see how much these are selling for. This is pretty neat down here. Snapships Tactics for $2.99. Some building ship game. $2.99 is a great deal. Take a look what it sells for, like $50 or something like that. Pretty crazy. I'm gonna have to check and make sure all the pieces are in this thing because it is heavy. So we'll see if it's worth it at $2.99, but I'm thinking it is. Here we go, guys. This is really cool. Clue the Office for $3.99, $4. You guys can see, I think after fees and after what I pay for it, I'll make about $14 on it. Again, this is kind of something I'd like to keep, but I gotta sell things. I can't keep everything, but I could play a round or two. Now I'm curious if there's anything that I missed in here, anything I didn't scan. Oh, this is really cool. Bed bugs. This might have a little bit of value too. We're gonna look into this. I've never seen it before. All right, I got the Bed Bugs game flipped over right here. I scanned it in with the Amazon seller app, and here it is selling for $40. And what are they asking for on it? $4. So that's a pretty good deal. Now, one thing I hate to see right here, it uses C batteries, so the batteries might be exploded in here. Only way to find out is by opening it up, taking a look. All right, so I was about to open it up and take a look, and I went to go pull on this, and it still has the original sticker seal on it. So this thing's new. That's crazy. I would have never guessed. So pretty sweet. Stick it in the cart. All right, so the toy section is pretty thoroughly gone through, but I turned the corner and there's more right down here. And I see a brand new sealed solar system kit. That might be good. And I think that's about it. So we'll take a look into that. All right, so I moved on over to the other side. The toys weren't worth it, the last one's remaining. And I noticed this over here. I love seeing the brand Melissa and Doug. Usually their stuff sells pretty fast. This is a Seek and Find sticker pad, brand new sealed. Scanned it in and take a look at that. It's gonna sell super fast, great reviews. For $17.92, I'll make $11.63. Now the question is, how much is it? I didn't even see a price on it. Oh, there we go, $3. So that's great. What, 11.10.98? Probably around $8 on it, even after shipping into Amazon. So that's a score that goes in the cart with all my other toys I still have to count pieces on. All right, I'm a few aisles over taking a look for anything I can find. I saw something kind of cool over here, this skeleton mug. And when I flipped it over, you could see it says Monster Jam Grave Digger. Pretty cool racing mug. I typed it in though, and take a look at this. Little disappointing, a lot of 2 for $50 and a single one for $6. Has no value. It's really cool though, but leaving it behind. All right, it looks like all blue tags are 50% off. So we're gonna take a quick look through the clothing, see if we can find anything blue 50% off, pretty cheap. You never know. Actually, is anything in my cart blue tag? That's a real question. Got green there, pink there. Probably not gonna be any blue in here. Oh, this is blue. So $2 for the Bed Bugs game, that's a great deal. The Office is four. Oh, the 1313's half off, so it's only $1. And then Candyland is pink. So I've been going through all the clothes here and I have not found anything to flip yet, but I found something for myself, which is always nice. We have a nice button up right here. It's an Under Armour, size medium. It fits beautiful. Blue tag right there, so $5. Can't go wrong. It's in great shape. You could probably flip this, honestly, for $20-25, but I think I'm getting it for myself for $5. Stick it in the cart and see if we can find anything else here. I'll show you guys basically what I'm seeing. I'm seeing lots of $10 tags. Nautica, Faded Glory, which is Walmart, for $7. John Blair, Basco, J. Crew for $10. Woolrich, $7. Woolrich, if it's all wool, can be really good. If it's cotton, don't even bother. J. Crew, $13. Peter England, $10. Express, $13. Kenneth Cole, $10. That's about the average, it looks like. Not seeing much, nothing interesting. Mossy Oak for $7. We'll see if we can find something though. There's gotta be at least one piece in all of this clothing here, right? You would think. All right, they say everybody finds all the heat at Goodwill. Flipping through and I think I found it. Where is it? Right here. I put ketchup on my ketchup. Is this an actual Heinz? It is an actual Heinz shirt for $3. That is, yeah, okay. Hey, Minnesota Wild, it's pretty sweet. My Arizona Coyotes, their last game is today. I'm gonna be watching it. I'm gonna be very sad because odds are they're relocating to Utah and they will not be the Coyotes anymore, and I don't know what I'm gonna do. I really don't. I'm even wearing my House of Heat Arizona State Sun Devils in support. I'll switch to a Coyotes shirt later. I don't know. I think we gotta count pieces in these board games and check a little bit more. Hey, here's another hockey shirt. We got the Hurricanes. These guys used to be the Hartford Whalers, so you see a lot of Hurricane stuff here because when they relocated to the Carolinas, you got people supporting them still. So I find Hurricane stuff all the time. And because we're in Connecticut, you find lots of Giant stuff. Who is that? Odell Beckham, I think. Yep, Beckham Jr. t-shirt for $7. Not a bad deal. I mean, he's not in the Giants anymore, so I don't know who would want that. But yeah, doesn't look like anything. Boston, who's that, Jason Tatum? Yeah, lots of sports stuff, $5. I mean, that's pretty good deals for sports shirts, especially if you get them on the half-off days. They're like $2-3. But today, not so much. All right, guys, this is always something I worry about when I'm thrifting. So Ashley, my girlfriend, is deadly allergic to peanut butter. And I opened up this box to count pieces and there's a melted Reese's peanut butter cup in here and it stained up all the artwork. So I'm not gonna get this, but if it was her here with me and she opened it up to count pieces, that would have been terrible. So yeah, I'm always worried about that. So I gotta be checking these things more, but that's gross. That's going back on the shelf. I feel bad because not everybody's allergic to peanut butter, but I think I might bring it up to the front counter actually and have them bring it in the back. If they put it back on the shelf, that's up to them, but I'm gonna let them know that there's melted candy all on the inside of this and that they should probably just toss it, which stinks. I don't know if all the pieces are in here, but it's kind of disgusting in there. It smells gross, so we'll see. Maybe they'll just throw it out. I'll check the Clue one right now. Hopefully there's not any melted candy in here. Let's see. I'll pop it open. I mean, this one's only, well, it's $4, so let's see. If it was a buck or two, I probably wouldn't even bother. I see all the player pieces right there. That's good. Lots of cards. I'm just gonna assume it's good, and I'll finish counting it. Actually, aren't there supposed to be weapons? Yeah, let's see. Uh-oh. Now, I don't know if there's weapon pieces. Oh, there they are. Okay, cool. I'm just gonna assume it's complete. I will do full counting at home, but for $4, I'd rather just not take up a spot inside the store here and count it. I'm willing to take that risk. So we'll stick it in here. And yeah, so that's pretty good. We'll bring that up to the counter. And I think we're gonna get out of here and possibly go to another thrift store. All right, we are down the toy aisle. Found something pretty cool here. Angry Birds Star Wars Jenga. And not only did I find one of these, I found two of them. They're both different, but these things can go for crazy money if they're new. These ones are used. I mean, it looks like it's new in there, but the box is all destroyed, so I highly doubt they're actually new. You can't sell them as new, but look at the box. Box damage is all over. But yeah, I'll pop up some prices so you guys can see. These things sell really, really well. They take a while to sell, but they sell for really good money, so we'll definitely grab them. Another item that sells really well is the Game of Life, Pirates of the Caribbean. Take a look at that price right there. Insane. Yeah, I don't know if all the pieces are in here. I'm gonna bust it open real quick and see how it looks. I'm not gonna count everything because the price is only $2.99. So if it's missing a few pieces in here, hey, it is what it is. I lost $3. I'm sure I could sell some parts for more than that. So we'll stick it in the cart for now, but maybe I'll look it up in a little bit. And I do want to show you guys a few things we got right here. Some DVDs. We got TLC 2010 WWE. You guys can see it's selling for some great money. It's brand new sealed also, so $3, not bad. Next, we have this Turner Classic Movies Greatest Legends, something like that. $1.99. I'll make some decent money on it. I'll take it. And then I didn't even look this up because the price was so good I threw it in the cart. Full House Complete DVD Series for $3.99. I mean, come on. That's a freaking score. That's going in the cart. So now I'm just looking around. So, what is right in front of my face here? Another Jenga Star Wars. And also white tags are 50% off. So it's only $5.99. We'll get it for $3. That's a score. Were these white tagged as well? Let's see. No, they're blue. Oh, I just realized this one's $15. I might have to put that one back. How much is this one? $6. Okay. $15 is kind of a lot. I gotta think about that. We'll leave it in here for now, though. So here's something kind of cool. I remember when these things came out, they were worth some pretty good money. It's a recoil frag grenade. It's some random grenade toy. I don't know. Oh, it says it has a blast radius. I really don't know. It's $4, though. Take a look at this price. I have it pulled up on Amazon right here. Has a great rank. Brand new. $30. Used. $56. So used prices are out of whack right now. So you could probably get, looks like it says low as 25. You could probably get $20 for this thing. It only costs a couple bucks, so we're grabbing it. All right, this is pretty interesting. So we have a Thomas and Friends, and I always keep an eye out for Thomas the Tank Engine because his stuff just sells really well. And it is brand new. The box has a little bit of wear. There's an old Target clearance sticker, $14. They actually have it priced a dollar higher than the Target clearance, which is kind of funny. But if you take a look over here, I'm using Scoutify to get into Camel, which is just a place to track prices. It's not in stock on Amazon, so I wanted to see what it sells for. Scroll down, and here is the price history, new. Looks like it last sold for $49. It sold as high as $70, $80. So I think it's worth it for $15. All right, I made my way over to the records, and look at all of this Elvis here. I mean, there is an unlimited amount of Elvis records here. It just keeps going and going and going. And then same thing right here. It's just every single one you can think of. Pretty crazy. I spent some time looking through every single one on Amazon. Now, it's difficult because a lot of these, they release different versions. I'm trying to get to the other ones. And you could see, like, this says ANL11319 way up there in the corner. It's an RCA release. So every release is a little bit different from the last. So it is difficult to know if you have, like, a rare pressing or something. I have no idea. But I grabbed what I believe to be the good ones here, at least with my limited knowledge. I also found two Pokemon VHS tapes. Pretty awesome, 99 cents each. They're not in the best condition packaging-wise. There's, like, a rip on that one. And then this one right here has a rip, which kind of stinks. Here are the records I got. We got Elvis as recorded at Madison Square Garden, pretty sweet. And then we got a nice little stack right here, Having Fun with Elvis on Stage, Elvis Today, Good Times. I don't know what that one says. Theater Sessions, maybe? The Sun Sessions. There we go. Spin Out. This is Burke Bacharach's Greatest Hits. Not Elvis, but still a good one. A Snoopy one. Pretty cool right here. And the Royal Guardsman. This is cool. Dance and Sing Mother Goose with a Beatle beat. It's kind of Mother Goose tales with Beatles. Very interesting. And then the last one, a date with Elvis. So all pretty sweet finds. Definitely going to make some money there. I just got to double check and make sure the records themselves are in good shape. So I'm flipping through some of the jackets and the clothing here, and I saw this little design right up here, and I'm like, it has to be a Giants thing. And it is. I can't tell if it's vintage or not. Like, this doesn't look vintage, but that kind of does. It's 25 bucks anyways, but it's like the satin material. But take a look at the stains on this thing. Pretty rough, pretty raunchy. On the back, it looks like the N was burnt with a cigarette or something. So that's a shame for 25 bucks. But I'm going to keep flipping through here and see if we get anything else. I don't think there's anything great here. There's 9/11, never forget, for $8. Oh, it's a champion? Oh, that's probably just a custom patch. Yeah, I'm just going to keep flipping through, see if anything cool pops up. I don't think so, though. So I was about to leave, and I came back over to the VHS section, and I saw somebody with a whole bunch of these Pokemon VHS tapes in their cart. So they put them all back, probably because they weren't worth that much, but they're so cool. Look at that. I have never even seen this one with Togepi and Pikachu. They're all 99 cents each. I looked it up, and the right one didn't even come up. But that one's going for $11, so there is money in them. A little bit, not a lot, but they're just so cool. I almost want them all. He had a lot more than this in his cart, so I'm sure he kept all the ones that were worth a decent amount. But I think at 99 cents each, I'm just going to grab them all, even if the covers aren't in perfect condition. They're just too cool to leave. Yeah, that one's in really rough shape. Let's see. What do we got here? Oh, yeah. I've seen this one a bunch of times. I think it's Thundershock. Yep, Thundershock. Oh, look at that one. That is really ripped up down there. What a shame. Oh, so cool, though. And then this guy. Togepi and Pikachu. Yeah, I'm just going to grab them all. Why not? 99 cents each. I'm sure I could build a bundle on eBay and get way more than that, but maybe they'll stay on my shelf for a little bit. I like them that much.